Good morning. In the name of our crucified and risen Savior, Jesus Christ, we want to welcome all of you to worship here with us at Lewinsville Presbyterian Church on this All Saints Sunday, November the 6th, 2022. All Saints Sunday is a day when the church calls to mind those whom we have lost during the last year, as well as all of those who have come before us. It is a day when we claim the resurrection promises of our faith, and when we remember that we are surrounded by a very great cloud of witnesses who are encouraging us, surrounding us, and cheering us on. We're so glad to have you joining us, whether you're joining us here in the sanctuary or whether you're joining us online at lewinsville.org or on our YouTube channel. In addition to remembering those members of Lewinsville Presbyterian Church who have died during the last year, which we will do in a formal way during the communion prayers today, our worship this morning is going to be filled with the music of the Misa, Criolla, which blends the rhythms and the music of Argentina with traditional worship texts as part of our celebration of the music of Hispanic cultures in worship here at Lewinsville Presbyterian. We are so grateful to all of our musicians who are joining us today and leading us in worship. There are bios of our musicians in your bulletins that we would encourage you to check out. We're also grateful to our choir for your spectacular leadership today in worship. Thank you so much for the preparation and the work that you all have done for today. We are really looking forward to the service this morning. At this time, I want to invite Zach Gutierrez, who is one of our section leaders here at Lewinsville, to come to the lectern to do a little bit of teaching with us about some pronunciation that is going to make it easier for us to experience the worship service this morning. Zach.
Thank you. Okay, everyone. We have two hymns in Spanish we're going to sing today. By the end of this, we'll all be native Spanish speakers, okay? If you can flip your hymnal to 397. We have three verses in Spanish, so I will go over the three verses, and then I will say it, and you'll repeat after me, okay? First verse, miren que bueno es cuando.
Miren que bueno es cuando.
Los hermanos están juntos.
Los hermanos están juntos.
Es como aceite bueno. Derramado sobre Aarón.
Derramado sobre Aarón.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Next verse. Miren que bueno es cuando.
Miren que bueno es cuando.
This is a little different. Las hermanas están juntas.
Las hermanas están juntas.
Se parece al rocío.
Se parece al rocío.
Sobre los montes de Sion. And the third verse. Miren que bueno es cuando.
Miren que bueno es cuando.
Nos reunimos todos juntos.
Nos reunimos todos juntos.
Porque el Señor ahí manda.
Porque el Señor ahí manda.
Vida eterna y bendición.
Vida eterna y bendición.
Perfect. And yes. Really good, everybody. And let's turn to Pan de Vida. I don't know if you have that in your bulletin, but we'll learn it.
So this is a hymn selection in your bulletins that you'll find the inserted language there just after the sermon, Pan de Vida.
So, first is Pan de Vida, Cuerpo del Señor.
Pan de Vida, Cuerpo del Señor.
Yep, and then we have some English. And then in our refrain, the Spanish at the end is poder es servir porque Dios, porque Dios es amor. And then our verses, first verse, somos el templo de Dios.
Somos el templo de Dios.
Frágiles,
frágiles
seres humanos. Oh, we're not singing all the verses. Y'all did a great job.
I was going to go with Zach Gutierrez. I'd give you just a reminder of the different banners that are around our sanctuary, which were put up last week for Reformation Sunday, and are leaving them up through this season, representing the different historical statements of faith from our denomination's Book of Confessions. After worship, we'd love for you to just make your way around and to check those out. Friends, if you are joining us online, we are particularly glad to have you with us, and we'd invite you to download the bulletin from the website so that you can follow along, and you may also want to gather together for yourselves the communion elements at this time, some bread and some wine or crackers and juice, so that those will be near at hand as we get to that part of the worship service today. Friends, wherever you have come from and wherever you are right now on your journey of faith, you are welcome here at Lewinsville Presbyterian Church. Would you please stand now as you're able and join me in the responsive call to worship that's printed in your bulletins. This is the day of resurrection. We come to God looking for re-creation. This is our day set aside for the Lord. We are learning to rest. This is the day that God has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Gracious and merciful, and knows our need even before it ever reaches our lips. Yet we still engage in confession, admitting to God all that rests uneasily in our hearts. And that is because the act of confessing our sin is not simply a recitation of our faults and wrongs, but also an opportunity to receive God's mercy and share in that abundant grace. So this morning, with that in mind, let us turn to God in confession, first with a prayer in our bulletin, followed by the prayer in our bulletins. Friends, let us turn to God in prayer. Let us pray. God of all saints and sinners, God of our mothers and fathers, God of all the faithful of every time and place, hear our prayer to you this day. We wish to live as your saints, holy, good, patient, loving, faithful, but so often we are aware of the ways we are sinful, selfish, mean, fearful, falling far short of your glory. Forgive us our sin and restore us to fullness of life. Forgive the wrong we have done and renew us in faith, hope, and love. Shape us by your Holy Spirit into the image of Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen. the good news. The love of God is beyond measure, and you are included in that love. Know that you are forgiven, and let that make you free to love and serve all people. Friends, hear and believe the good news that comes from God. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Received us, pardoned us, and loved us. Let us stand and share that love with one another. Friends, hear the good news of the gospel. The peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Amen.
I want to invite any of the children in the sanctuary who want to come up here to the front for our children's meditation to come on up here, and we'll hang out here for a little bit and talk. Others may be seated. How about that music, huh? That is strong, strong stuff. So I am so glad to see you all and to have you all here. So today, you want to come sit up here or you can sit on the carpet, either one. So glad you're here. So today is a day in the church's year that we call All Saints Sunday. And one of the things that we do on All Saints Sunday is that we especially remember people in our congregation and in our lives who have died during the past year. And so a little bit later in the worship service, when we're having communion, you're going to see Pastor Jen, who is sitting right over there. Pastor Jen is going to be behind the communion table. And you can see over there, there's a little candelabra that has seven candles that are lit. It's kind of behind the flowers, so you may have to bend around to see it. Each one of those candles represents the name of someone in this congregation who was a member of Lewinsville who died during the past year. And there's a list of those six people in the bulletin. And then there's a seventh candle there that represents other people who have died who aren't members of Lewinsville but who were dear to different people who have died during the past year. So Jen's going to read the names of those persons, and as she does so, John is going to ring a bell for each one of those names. So you'll hear that a little bit later in the worship service as we remember people from the congregation who have died during the past year. So one of the things I want to say about all of that is that that does mean that there is a certain sense in which All Saints Sunday can be kind of a sad day because we're remembering people who have died. And so as you look around the sanctuary during that part, you may see different ones. Some of us cry pretty easily. I tend to cry pretty easily, and other people here do as well. And you may see people crying when we get to that part of the service because people are remembering someone that they have loved a whole lot who has died. And being sad is a part of our faith experience. It's a part of loving people. And so being sad, one of my favorite songs is a song that the main line in the song is, "It's all right to cry." And so you may see people crying around here, and sometimes, I don't know if this happens to you, but sometimes when I see somebody else crying, that then makes me start to cry. And that's part of what it means to be a person who's learning to love other people, and sometimes it happens that losses come to us in that way. So that's all held within God's love and God's grace on this day. Why don't we say a prayer together, and then if you'd like to go out to sermon stories, you can do that with Ms. Lineberger after this. Let's pray. On All Saints Sunday, dear God, we thank you for your presence with us, and we thank you for the people whom we have loved who have died. We give you thanks for the impact they've had on us, and we ask that you would surround us with your Spirit as we feel sad and as we feel grateful to have known them and to have received so many gifts from them. Bless us, we pray. All these things in Christ's name. Amen. Thank you all for coming up. You can either go back and sit with your families, or if you want to go out with Ms. Lineberger to sermon stories, you can do that.
Let us come before the Lord in prayer. Guide us, O God, by your word and Holy Spirit, that in your light we may see light, in your truth find freedom, and in your will discover your peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Old Testament reading today is another psalm, not the one that Scott mentioned earlier, but Psalm 98, and you can find it on page 551 in your pew Bible. Listen now for the word of God. Oh, sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have gotten him victory. The Lord has made known his victory. He has revealed his vindication in the sight of the nations. He has remembered his steadfast love and faithfulness to the house of Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Break forth in joyous song and sing praises. Sing praises to the Lord with the lyre and the sound of melody. With trumpets and the sound of the horn, make a joyful noise before the King, the Lord. Let the sea roar and all that fills it, the world and those who live in it. Let the floods clap their hands. Let the hills sing together for joy at the presence of the Lord. For he is coming to judge the earth. He will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with equity. The word of the Lord. Our gospel reading today is from the book of Luke, chapter 20, verses 27 through 38. And it can be found on page 84 in the New Testament section of your pew Bible. Please listen again for the word of the Lord. Some Sadducees, those who say there is no resurrection, came to him and asked him a question. Teacher, Moses wrote for us that if a man's brother dies, leaving a wife but no children, the man shall marry the widow and raise up children for his brother. Now there were seven brothers. The first married and died childless. Then the second and the third married her. And so in the same way, all seven died childless. Finally, the woman also died. In the resurrection, therefore, whose wife will the woman be? For the seven had married her. Jesus said to them, those who belong to this age marry and are given in marriage. But those who are considered worthy of a place in that age and in the resurrection from the dead neither marry nor are given in marriage. Indeed, they cannot die anymore, because they are like angels and are children of God, being children of the resurrection. And the fact that the dead are raised, Moses himself showed in the story about the bush, where he speaks of the Lord as the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. Now he is God not of the dead, but of the living, for to him all of them are alive. The word of the Lord.
Friends, let us turn to God in prayer. On this All Saints Sunday, O God, we give you thanks and we give you praise for those who have come before us. We give you thanks for your resurrection power at work in their lives and at work in our own. Help us, dear Lord, to live as children of the resurrection. Help us to live as those whose lives are willingly transformed by your grace and by your Spirit. Through Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen. So I'm wondering if you have ever had a mentor or a teacher, someone whose life expressed for you the kind of joy and grace and kindness that embodied the good life. A life lived with God, a life that showed you what was possible in your own life. One of those persons for me is someone I have mentioned to you all before, a teacher of mine in seminary named Shirley Guthrie. Shirley died in 2004 and was a genius of a theological scholar. Shirley did his PhD work with Karl Barth at the University of Basel in Switzerland. Shirley was funny, really funny. He was from Texas, and he had a Texas kind of humor, and he was very, very kind. And one of my classmates used to say that what she loved the most about Shirley was that you could just tell that Shirley loved Jesus. One time in theology class, we were talking about the resurrection and about the communion of saints and the New Testament's view of heaven. And Shirley said something about heaven that has become fundamental to my own thinking about heaven and about the life of the resurrection. Shirley said, "Whatever you think heaven is going to be like, heaven is going to be far better than anything you can possibly comprehend. Whatever you think heaven is going to be like, heaven is going to be far better than anything you can possibly comprehend. The communion of saints, which we are recognizing in a particular way today, is about the radical transformation of life through the resurrection." Now, Shirley was not saying that if you think heaven's going to be like winning $1 million, it's actually going to be like winning $1 billion. Heaven is not simply going to be some extension of life as we know it, not simply taking something that we already know and then dialing it up to the nth degree. As my dear friend Tom Schmidt used to say, Tom was pastor at Falls Church Presbyterian for a number of years, and he used to say, I am told, every year in his Easter sermons, quoting the legendary Roman Catholic theologian Hans Kuhn, "The resurrection should never be understood as a resuscitation, as the return from sleep to the prior state of things. The resurrection, which we're talking about today with the communion of saints, the resurrection is a radical transformation into an utterly new state of being." Anybody who was in one of Tom Schmidt's sermons knows this, Jordans. The resurrection, the kingdom of heaven, and the communion of saints are all about the radical transformation of life as we know it into the wondrous purposes of God. In the text from Luke 20 that Ruth just read for us, Jesus is approached by a group of religious leaders known as the Sadducees. The Sadducees were Jewish aristocrats who were known for making politically convenient compromises with the Roman imperial authorities. They did not, the text says, believe in the resurrection. And one wonders whether part of the reason why the Sadducees did not believe in the resurrection was because of the inherently subversive nature of the resurrection. For when you are at the top of the social power structure, the radical transformation of life as we know it may not be exactly what you're looking for. So they come and they ask Jesus a question, and they tell him this story, quoting Moses, about Moses' teaching, that they seem to believe this question is perfectly crafted to make Jesus admit that the resurrection cannot be, for it cannot be in accord with Moses and Moses' teaching. So they take a teaching that was originally designed in order to provide for the vulnerability of a widow, and they take it and they distort it into a way to try to engage Jesus in verbal combat, trying to leave Jesus in humiliation. But it turns out that Jesus is not really threatened by them, not really intimidated by their intellectual firepower, and he tells them that they are missing the entire point. For the resurrection is not simply like overtime in the Alabama LSU game. The resurrection is not simply an extension of life as we know it under the same conditions as we understand it now. The resurrection and the communion of saints are about a radical transformation into an utterly new state of being, a way of life that is deeper and brighter and better than we can possibly comprehend. As Jesus says in the text, in the resurrection, they cannot die anymore because they are like angels. And they are like children of God, being children of the resurrection. Friends, on All Saints Sunday, the church celebrates the mystery of the communion of saints, which is about the radical transformation of life as we know it. We remember the lives of those dear to us who have died. We do not need to fully comprehend the nature of the mystery of the communion of saints in order to draw energy and courage from the ways that the saints are present with us this day in some mysterious way to cheer you on, to encourage you in the face of every challenge that you are encountering in your life. The life of the resurrection, the transformation of life as you know it, is coming to you. It's coming into our world. It is healing the broken, opening the eyes of those who cannot and will not see clearly, bringing good news to the poor, and delivering new life to people and organizations and communities that have become like dead. The life of heaven is far better than anything we can possibly comprehend. To God and to God alone be all of the glory. Amen. Friends, let us pray. For your great power, O God, at work in the church and in the world, we give you praise. Forgive us when we take you for granted. Forgive us when we do not trust your Spirit. Forgive us when we think that you have no more gifts to give. Open our minds and open our hearts to live with courage and joy, knowing that we are being made new right this moment by your Spirit. Through Christ we pray. Amen.
standing and reciting our affirmation of faith together, the choir will be singing it. So in response to God's word read and proclaimed this morning, we will affirm our faith in our hearts while the choir lifts our faith in song. So let us worship God. Flowers this morning are given in the glory to God in the celebration of the 50th wedding anniversary of Dale and Carolyn Hodges, which they celebrated on November 4th. Thank you. I hope your celebrations were wonderful. I also at this time would invite the congregation to pass the red hand of greeting pad, which you can find at the end of your pews. Thank you so much for leaving your information, and I would encourage you to use the information to get to know the folks who are sitting around you. Today we share prayer requests at this time because our prayers of the people will be part of the communion liturgy in a little bit. And Marie Highland sent a prayer request asking the congregation to pray for her friend Kiyoki Sato, who was diagnosed with bone cancer this week. Friends, as we prepare to give our offerings today, I would like to remind you about the Lewinsville Music Fund. It was founded in 1987. And this music fund strives to enhance and strengthen the music program here at our congregation through significant instrumental expenses, enhancement to the music program, and special music programs. Also, as many of you know, we are in the season of stewardship and would like to remind folks that you can still turn in your pledge cards if you have not yet done so. We are so incredibly grateful for the generosity of this congregation, and you make so much possible here at Loonsville, such as the music, wonderful music that we are experiencing this morning. You can place your pledge cards in the offering plate if you would like, or you can do so online by clicking the Make a Pledge button. Also, today is the first Sunday of the month, so in addition to our regular offering, we are also collecting for the Deacons Fund. You can contribute by going online to the giving page and click on the Deacons Fund button. The pastors and the deacons use these funds to provide emergency to folks in our congregation and emergency funds to those in our community. Friends, as we enter this time of offering, we do so with gratitude for all the gifts that God has given us. Let us worship God with our offering.
Remember me, though I have to say goodbye, remember me. Don't let it make you cry, for even if I'm far away, I hold you in my heart. I sing a secret song to you, each night we are apart.
Even when they shall come from the east and west, and from the north and south to sit at the table in the presence of the Lord, there is going to be enough room. At this table, there is always an extra seat. At this table, no one sits alone. At this table, no one goes hungry. And the empty places at our own tables, the seats no longer filled by those we love, they are remembered, and they are held here at this table, filled by the love of Christ who never lets us go, and certainly not in our grief. Come to this table, all of you who trust in the Lord, for there is room and there is enough. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. God of the ages, we praise you for all your servants who have done justice, loved mercy, and walked humbly with their God, for apostles and martyrs and saints of every time and place, who in life and death have witnessed to your truth, we praise you, O God. For all those who have faithfully served you, witnessed bravely and died in faith, and who are still shining lights in the world, we praise you, O God, porque Dios es amor. From every race and tongue, people and nation, you have gathered saints into your kingdom. You've shown them the path of life and filled them with the joy of your presence. How glorious is your heavenly realm, where the multitude of your saints rejoice with Christ. Renew our communion with all your saints, especially those whom we name before you who have died this year. Allison Bauer. Patsy Duke. Elizabeth McKenna. Jack Pearl. Mary Ann Phillip. Steve Stevenson. Friends and family known to each of us here today. You have surrounded us with a great cloud of witnesses, saints and faithful people in every age, that strengthened by their witness, supported by their fellowship, we may run with perseverance the race set before us, and with them receive the unfading crown of glory. Therefore, we join with the saints, with the faithful of every time and place, in proclaiming your glory.
Oh,
in prayer, we praise you, God, for sending Jesus to tell your story, heal the sick, and be a friend to sinners. We praise you, he overcame death and is risen to rule the world. And we believe that when he comes in glory, we will celebrate victory with him. Remembering all your mighty and merciful acts, we break bread and share one cup. So, gracious God, pour out your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ. Through Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit and the glory and honor of God, we pray together the prayer that Jesus taught us to say. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. And so it was on the night of Jesus' betrayal that he took the bread, and after giving thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body broken for you, and do this in remembrance of me." And then in the same manner, after supper, Jesus took the cup, and after giving thanks, he blessed it and poured it, and gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink this, all of you. This cup is the new covenant shed for you through my blood for the forgiveness of sins. Drink this in remembrance of me." And now as often as we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's saving death until he comes again. Today's communion will be received by intinction, so the ushers will indicate when, after the choir, you would come up to the front to receive bread and to take from the tray. On the outside, there is wine. On the inside, the darker is grape juice. If you prefer to stay in your seat to receive communion, Pastor Lane will be bringing that to you. And if you need gluten-free, please indicate that when you come up. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Oh,
And now let us join together in the prayer after the supper and let us pray. God of all mercy, we give you thanks and praise for this meal of grace. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. May we who drink his cup bring life and refreshment to others. May we whom the Spirit lights on fire give your light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Friends, let's have a round of appreciation for our musicians who've been leading us today. As we are preparing now to follow our Lord Jesus Christ out into the world, I want to draw your attention to the announcements at the back of the bulletin and call attention to a few of them specifically. The next module of adult Christian education classes began this morning. Rachel Russell and Linton Brooks are leading a class entitled The Difficult Words of Jesus, and I am leading a class in the four-year cycle of 101 classes. This year's class is Spiritual Practices 101. If you missed this morning's classes, you can always join again next Sunday when we gather at 9:30. This afternoon at 4 o'clock p.m., we're going to be having an afternoon contemplative service of remembrance for All Saints Sunday. There will be music provided here in the sanctuary, as well as opportunities for a prayer walk out in the cemetery, opportunities for praying with a pastor or with a deacon, and more. Everyone is invited to join in this time this afternoon as we remember together those whom we have lost during this past year, as well as other losses that we've experienced in our lives. This coming Saturday morning, November the 12th, from 9:30 to 11 o'clock, the Faith and Public Policy Committee is hosting a breakfast here at the church featuring a presentation by Kim Bobo, who is the Executive Director of the Virginia Interfaith Center for Public Policy. There's going to be a continental breakfast there, and Kim is going to be talking with us about some of the legislative issues that are going to be coming before the Virginia General Assembly in their upcoming session. You can register for this event on the events section of our webpage or via the link in the announcement in the bulletin. And James Foster is here waving his hand right now, and you can ask James questions about that after worship. Next Sunday, November the 13th, following the worship service, is the annual meeting of the Lewinsville Retirement Residents. All persons who are members of Lewinsville Presbyterian Church are also members of the corporation for LRR, and so you're invited to stick around next Sunday to learn more about the very great impact that LRR is having on our neighborhood right here in our neighborhood. At the end of the bulletin, you'll also find the page for submitting nominations for church officers, which we would commend to you, and you can either place that in a box in the church office or via a link on the website. The nominating committee is in the midst of its process to discern the leadership of this congregation in the years coming up. Finally, we do want to encourage folks to vote this coming Tuesday, November the 8th, if you have not already done so. Participating in our public civic life in constructive ways is one of the mandates of our Reformed tradition as we seek to build the common good together. So we encourage everyone who is eligible to vote this coming Tuesday, November the 8th. Friends, as we are preparing now to follow our Lord Christ out into the world on this All Saints Sunday, let's stand for our final hymn, For All the Saints. Let's stand and sing together.
Oh,
Friends, you and I are surrounded. We are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses from every age. Saints who have come before us, loved ones who have come before us. We are surrounded as we go throughout our days. And I am struck standing here right now of how frequently I am just completely unaware of that. We go throughout our days completely unaware, mindless, as though we have to do this journey on our own. We do not. We are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses on every side, made possible by the grace of Jesus Christ. So friends, go forth into your lives, into our world this week, and go forth with your heads held up high, hearts full of courage, full of compassion, full of mercy. And may the grace of Jesus Christ our Lord, may the love of God Almighty, and may the presence and the power and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be upon you, around you, and within you in ways that you are conscious and aware for the days of this week, for the rest of your lives, and out into all eternity. Amen.
Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.